My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us to fear Him. As we all know that Allah also ordered us to repent back to Him and to seek forgiveness from our sins. And it has been mentioned in many verses in the Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called and described Himself Al-Ghaffar, the forgiver. And this is for us to remember how important it is for us to seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to repent back to Him. Even the prophets and the messenger of Allah, they seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they repent back to Him, where they were among the ones whom Allah saved them from the sins and saved them from the mistakes in their lives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran about our parents, Adam and Eve, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. This is our fathers, father and mother, our parents. They repent back to Allah and they ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They said, Our Lord, we have been injustice to ourselves. If thou forgive us not and have not mercy on us, we will be certainly among the losers. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran about Nuh alayhi salam, the one who called his people for 950 years, but he also seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says in the Quran, in the tongue of Nuh alayhi salam, وَإِلَّا تَغْفِرْ لِي وَتَرْحَمْنِي أَكُمْ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. If thou forgive me and have not mercy in me, I shall be among the losers. And this is Musa alayhi salam. Allah also mentioned about him in the Quran that he repent back to Allah and asked the forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Musa, in the tongue of Musa, رَبِّ إِنِّي ظَلَمْتَ نَفْسِي فَغْفِرْ لِي فَغَفَرَ لَهُ. My Lord, surely I have done harm to myself, so do thou protect me. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected him. And this is Dawood. Allah mentioned him in the Quran that he repented and asked Allah for the forgiveness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the tongue of Dawood, فَاسْتَغْفَرَ رَبَّهُ وَخَرَّ رَاكِعًا وَأَنَابِ. Sought the protection of his Lord and fell down bowing and turning time after time to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is Sulaiman alayhi salam. Allah also mentioned that he asked the forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's been mentioned in the Quran. Allah subhanahu says in the tongue of Sulaiman alayhi salam, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَهَبْ لِي مُلْكًا لَا يَنْبَغِي لِأَحَدٍ مِّن بَعْدِي. My Lord, do thou forgive me and grant me a kingdom which is not fit being inherited by anyone after me. And this is our lovely Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also Allah commanded him and ordered him to seek for the forgiveness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in the tongue of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. Ask protection of your fault and for the believed man and for the believing women. My dear brothers and sisters, if the prophets and messengers seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What about us, the weak people? They were among the ones whom Allah saved them from the sins and saved them from the mistakes. But we are doing mistakes and sins day and night. But look to the beautiful hadith which Allah mentioned in the tongue of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which called the hadith al-Qudsi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ibadi, innakum tukhti'una bil-layli wal-nahar, wa ana aghfiru al-dunuba jami'a, fastaghfiruni aghfir lakum. Allahu Akbar. O servant, O my servant, you sin by night and by day, and I forgive all the sins. So seek forgiveness of me, and I shall forgive you. It is very important that every one of us seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in order to be successful here and thereafter. There is a lot of benefits for seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is a reason to delete the sin, and expiation of evil. As it's mentioned in the hadith al-Qudsi, seek forgiveness of me and I shall forgive you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned in many verses in the Quran, and one of them says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ سُوءًا أَوْ يَظْلِمْ نَفْسًا ثُمَّ يَسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهَ يَجِدِ اللَّهَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. And whoever does evil or act injustice to his soul, then seek forgiveness of Allah, he shall find Allah the most forgiver and the most merciful. May Allah forgive us and put mercy upon us all. And look to what Anas radiallahu anhu says, that he have heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that Allah said, Ya ibn Adam, innaka ma da'awtani wa rajawtani ghafartu laka ma kana minka wa la ubali. Ya ibn Adam, Ya ibn Adam, لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء, لو بلغت ذنوبك عنان السماء ثم استغفرتني غفرت لك ولا أبالي. Anas said that he have heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah said, O son of Adam, she'll go and forgiving, she'll go and forgiving you so long as you pray to me and aspire for my forgiveness, whatever may it be your sins. O son of Adam, I do not care even if your sins shall build up to the sky, and shall you be burdened of me, I would forgive you. My dear brothers and sisters, seeking the forgiveness of Allah, it's very easy. But does everyone remember that Allah is the most forgiver and the most merciful? We do sin day and night, as the Prophet approved this. But we have to repent back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to seek the forgiveness of Him. Another benefit of seeking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is a safe for us from the penalty and from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Nor is Allah going to punish them while yet they ask for forgiveness. We ask Allah all for forgiveness. And more benefits for seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a reason for relieving the worries, bringing the livelihood, and getting out of the stress. So for those who are worries in their life, who are worries about their income, who are worries about their children, who are worries about their wife, about their life, about anything in life, look what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has mentioned in the hadith. مَنْ لَزِمَ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مِنْ كُلِّ ضِيقٍ مَخْرَجًا وَمِنْ كُلِّ هَمٍ فَرَجًا وَرَزَقَهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. The Messenger of Allah said, if anyone continuously and put lines under continuously, seek pardon from Allah, Allah will appoint for him a way out of every distress and a relief from every anxiety, and will provide sustain for him from where he expected not. So if you are among those who seek for the wealth, who seek for the good childs, who seek for the waters, rains, seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And more benefits of seeking forgiveness, it is a reason for decay of the rain, wealth, sun, gardens, the availability of waters. And this has happened in the time of Al-Hasan al-Basri radiallahu anhu. He was in the gathering with his students and people coming back and forth asking him questions. One of the people come and he said, "Oh Shaykh, I am very poor, I have no income." Then Al-Hasan al-Basri told him, "You go back and seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Another one come and he said, "I've been married for a long time and I haven't got a child yet." Al-Hasan al-Basri told him the same thing, "You go back and seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Another person came and he said, we are in need for the rain. Hasan al-Basri said, "You go back and you seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." A fourth person came and he said, "We are in need for the waters." And Hasan al-Basri said, "You go back and you ask Allah and you seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." The students of Al-Hasan al-Basri were so surprised because different students are coming with different questions, with different circumstances, with different conditions. But the answers of Hasan al-Basri was the same. They asked Al-Hasan al-Basri, "Oh Shaykh, radiallahu anhu, all of them came with different circumstances, but you told them to go back and seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." Then look what Al-Hasan al-Basri said, "Don't you know that Allah revealed a verse in the Quran, in the tongue of Nuh alayhi salam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَقُلْتَ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا." Subhanallah al-Azim. This is what Allah says in the Quran, in the tongue of Noah. "Then I said, ask forgiveness of your Lord. Surely He is the most forgiving. He will sound down upon you the clouds, brooding down abundance of rain, and help you with wealth and sons, and make for you a gardens, and make for you a rivers. This is the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has the power above everything. Didn't we not believe in Allah's word? We have to go back and seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we really need what Allah mentioned in the Quran. If we really need the wealth, rains, the suns, the gardens, the rivers, you seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the tongue of Dawood alayhi salam, وَيَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيَزِدْكُمْ قُوَّةً إِلَى قُوَّتِكُمْ. O my people, ask forgiveness of your Lord. Then turn to Him. He will send on you clouds, pour down abundance of rain, and add strength to your strength. For the weak people, if you really need the strength, doesn't have to be the strength in muscle. It can be the strength in prayer. It can be the strength in education. It can be the strength in anything. Seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is no limitation for seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those who get really frustrated waiting in the red signals, ask the forgiveness in this time. For those who are really waiting for a meeting, for any case of this world life, ask the forgiveness in this availability time, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most forgiver and the most merciful. And there is special times and conditions for seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have done. It is after the prayer. We are just finishing the worshiping. But we are looking for the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after every prayer, he make three times istighfar, asking for forgiveness. And who is the Prophet? The one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all his sins. But after every prayer, he make three times istighfar and seeking for forgiveness. Do we do that? No. I have saw a lot of people, they just break off the prayer and they just jump to follow up their businesses in this life. Seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very important, my dear brothers and sisters. And also the special time of seeking forgiveness is after the night prayers. Every one of us should ask himself, am I among the ones who wake up in the night and do the prayer nights and sit after the prayer night and make istighfar, seeking forgiveness until the fajr time? These are the truth believers, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned them in the Quran, and He says, كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون. They used to sleep but little in the night, and in the morning they ask and seek for the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, it is very important that we keep seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Allah to make us among those who continuously asking and seeking forgiveness of Allah. My dear brothers and sisters, seeking forgiveness can happen anytime and anywhere. And as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that after the gathering, it is very important that we seek the forgiveness of Allah. And look what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says: "إن تكلم بخير كان طابعا عليهن إلى يوم القيامة وإن تكلم بغير ذلك كان كفارة له ألا وهو سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أستغفرك وأتوب إليك." When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sit in a gathering or prayed, he said some words, and Aisha asked him about these words, because after every gathering, it doesn't have to be a gathering of a business gathering, it can be a family gathering, it can be a friendshood gathering, any kind of gathering. Then she see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam keep saying some words after the family gathering. She asked him, "O Prophet, what's the words that you are saying?" He said, "If he has spoken some good words and he says this statement of remembrance, it will be a seal for them to preserve them until the day of resurrection." Allahu Akbar. "And if he has said something other than that, if this words, it will be an expiation for him. It is سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أستغفرك وأتوب إليك." Glory and praise to you, O Allah, I seek your forgiveness and I repent back to you. So it is very important after every gathering we have to say these words. It's very easy to remember for those who do not remember them. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. And the companions, they said, if we are in a gathering with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inna la nu'addu lirrasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam fi almajlis alwahid 100 marra yaqul rabb ighfir li wa tub alayya innaka antat tawwabur rahim. He said, "My Lord, forgive me and pardon me. Thou art the pardoning and forgiving one." So you are the one who Allah forgive the sins. This is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Tuba liman wujida fi sahifatihi istighfaran kathira." The Prophet said, glad tidings to those who find a lot of seeking forgiveness in the record of their deeds. And there is some words, or the way how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and make istighfar, such as رب اغفر لي وتب علي إنك أنت التواب الرحيم استغفر الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه. And سيد الاستغفار, which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, this is سيد الاستغفار, أن يقول العبد اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك وعلى عهدك ووعدك ما استطعت أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت أبو إليك بنعمتك علي وأبو إليك بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. من قالها من النهار موقنا بها فمات من يومه قبل أن يمسي فهو من أهل الجنة كما قال رسول الله. ومن قالها من الليل وهو موقن بها فمات قبل أن يصبح فهو من أهل الجنة كما قال رسول الله. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says the best supplication of seeking forgiveness is to say, "Oh Allah, you are my Rabb, you are my Lord. There is no true God except you. You have created me and I am your slave, and I hold to your covenant as far as I can. I seek refuge in you from the evil of what I have done. I acknowledge the favorites that you have bestowed upon me, and I confess my sins, pardoning me for none but you have the power to pardon." Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam add, "He who supplicates in these terms during the day with firm believing in it, and he dies in the same day before the evening, he will be one of the dwellers of Jannah. And if anyone supplicates in these terms during the night with firm belief in it, and he dies before the morning, he will be one of the dwellers of Jannah. Didn't we not want to be among those people of the dwellers of Jannah? We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the strength to remember him more and more, and to seek the forgiveness and to repent back to him. آمين أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا ما أسررنا وما أعلنا وما أنت سبحانك أعلم به منا اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن له حق علينا اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا كريم اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا اللهم اغفر لنا ما أسررنا وما أعلنا وما أنت سبحانك أعلم وما أنت سبحانك أعلم به منا وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك الحمد لله.